let's look at the parent graph of y equals the square root of x and all its variations. First, to understand where it comes from, you may want to consider y squared equals x, which is related to this graph. Let's look at the graph of that. Okay, it's a parabola, but it's oriented sideways. The vertex is at the origin. It curves to the right like this. Now, if I want to change that, if I want to solve for y, then we'd get y is plus or minus the square root of x, which is slightly different than that. Here's y. The top half of this curve is the y equals square root of x. The bottom half of the curve is y equals negative square root of x. Each half of that is a function, but the whole thing taken together is not a function because it violates the vertical line. It's going to cross two times, right, for any given x value. So when we're graphing this equation or some variation of it, it's always going to be a curve that looks like the top half of a sideways parabola, like that. The parent graph has its vertex at the origin and curves up above the x-axis. As we found out just now, you can change where the curve goes. If there's a negative in front of the parent graph, then the curve is going to go like this instead. If you multiply by different numbers, you're going to get different widths. The curve will change. But today we're going to focus on the h and k values. Just like in previous graphs, we can consider h and k as horizontal and vertical shifts from the parent graph. There's two forms of the function. You can either put the k there, or you could put the k on the side with the y, where it shows the opposite of k. So just remember, if you see that constant value added or subtracted here, that's the actual k value. But if it's on this side, it would be the opposite of the k value. The h value has to be inside the radical with the x, and it is the opposite of h. For example, how do we graph this? Well, in this case, the vertex is going to be at the opposite of negative 3, and there's no k value, so that's just 0. So here's our vertex, and the shape is the same as a parent graph. Now let's compare that with the square root of x minus 3. In this case, the minus 3 is outside the radical, so now it's the k value out there. So how does that change the graph? That's going to be a vertical shift. So now our vertex is at 0, negative 3, but the shape is the same. All right, let's talk about domain and range in these two examples also. Notice that the x values start at the vertex and then go to the right. So for the domain, we would say that x has to be greater than or equal to that vertex value. How about the range? Similarly, the y values start at the vertex and go up. And you might not think that's going to go up forever because it looks so almost horizontal as it's going up in this direction. But it is not a horizontal line. It is going to go up forever and ever and ever. If you picked a large enough x value, you would see that the y values are just increasing forever. So the y values start at the vertex, which is in this case 0, and go up from there. In our second example, the x values start at 0. So x can be greater than or equal to 0. And the range starts down at negative 3. So y can be greater than or equal to negative 3. All right, that should give you a head start on how to graph square root functions. You should be ready to do your homework now.